What's up, YouTube? My name is Lincoln Williams, and this is season 7 of the Lincoln Williams Show. That's right, we are back on the air for more videos for the summer, basically. We're making more videos than ever before because, as you can tell in the right window on that little screen of yours, what you're seeing right there. It's actually kind of embarrassing, but it's not entirely noticeable. Let's just scoot over just a little bit so you can see my face. But anyways, the good question is to start off with this season with a brand new season of the Lincoln Williams Show, new camera, new reviews, a new everything about the show is, the good question is, how am I recording? Now, that is a very good question. How am I recording this game? How am I recording this footage, basically? Well, it actually is quite different. The textures are a little bit off in some areas, but it overall looks great. Is it my phone? Is it my phone that I've been using for the past, 2 years on the Lincoln Williams Show? I don't know. Is it my iPad from the school?
You're kind of wrong about those devices that I'm using, basically. So no, it's not my iPad. No, it's not my phone. It is my brand new laptop. This is my brand new laptop that I'm recording from. And you can actually see how powerful it actually really is during a recording session, basically. So yeah, my new laptop is called the Acer Aspire E15 E5575-53VG. Well, basically, it's called the Acer. It's the model number is E5. It's the Acer Aspired E15 E5-75G/53VG. It's actually a very complicated number, but if you can put those into specs, if you look up Acer E15 laptops, then this one has here's a funny story. So here's a funny story about this laptop, basically. So I was looking at laptops, and I was looking at the Acer Aspired E15 series, all these different laptops, and me and my brother were searching for laptops, and he came across this one, and I'm like, what the heck is this? So I clicked on it, and I was inspecting him on this laptop, and I was like, what the heck is this? And I'm like, and he was like, well, it has an NVIDIA GeForce. Let me tell you the information it has. So we were looking at the Acer Aspired E15 E5 575G/53VG, basically, just to get the, because if you want to look at this laptop that I purchased, then go for it. You should look at it because it is one of the best traditional laptops that I've ever used, period. It could be used for work, it could be used for gaming, it could be used for any kind of video chat like you see right here, right now, with Skype, and it's crazy good, it's crazy awesome in that richness of a laptop that you rarely even see. So let's look at the specs of the Acer Aspire E15. Now, this is not a full review yet. I'm showing you the specs of the laptop just so we're clear, I'm going to be reviewing the laptop in really good depth of games. I'm going to be testing a few more games out on this laptop, like for next week, because I'm probably going to get like Fallout New Vegas for the PC, because, you know, why am I getting Fallout New Vegas again? Well, my parents have the PS3 in the living room, so I don't really want to take it from them. And then there's this, and the game is $5 on Steam, basically. Fallout New Vegas is $5 on Steam. So, yeah, I'm going to get Fallout New Vegas, basically. But anyways, on to the specs of the laptop. Basically, we have an Intel Core i5-6200U, 2.3 gigahertz with turbo boost up to 2.8 gigahertz. With an NVIDIA GeForce 940MX with 2GB dedicated VR RAM, 8GB of DDR4 memory, and 256GB SSD. And it also has a GDDR5 better graphics performance, a USB 3.1 reusable Type-C connector, a ultra-fast wireless, and... I warn you, yeah, and the wireless is really fast on this thing. It's really fast, and it's really precise. It's ultra-fast wireless, AC Extra Color, Acer True Harmony on the sound, certified for Skype and for business calls like this one, basically. So, yes. So, here's the embarrassing thing about this laptop. Here is the most embarrassing thing about this laptop, basically. So, you know, the most embarrassing thing about this laptop is when I'm right next to my dad, when I'm right next to my dad's PC, say I'm like right next to my dad's PC, basically. Or my friend Christopher Nickel. You know him from the unboxings. Hi, Chris. All right, in the audience. But if I'm sitting right next to him on a gaming machine like this, it's crazy. Because here's the most embarrassing thing about this laptop. Basically, it's not really bad. It's nothing bad. Everything about this laptop is super, super smooth. So smooth that it makes my dad's computer and my friend's computer look worse. I mean, not worse, but the speed on this thing. The speed is clocked in at so many, like, you know, okay, so that last bit on the laptop description. So here's three letters. Here are three letters to define this laptop's, like, processing power. Here's how my laptop processing power, here's the processing power. What type of chip does it use with the laptop inside it to make it go faster? Three words. SSD. The SSD somehow makes the laptop run even more faster than a regular computer, basically. The SSD is a way faster processor than most PC laptops, basically. Most laptops don't even come with an SSD inside them. It's just like, okay, you're done. You don't get an SSD unless you pay extra $50 for this one. But so yeah, this was a $550 laptop, basically. Yeah, it was crazy when I found this thing online for a crazy good amount of price. That price shouldn't even exist for this laptop.
But it actually does. And it's actually really, you know, good and well performed. So yeah, that is the overall laptop and its overall specs. I will have to, I'll do a full review on the laptop so that you can get a full experience out of the laptop. Like, I'll test the DVD drive. I'll test the DVD drive with PC games. This is Torchlight, basically. So I'm going to test Torchlight out. Dang it. Yeah, it actually does that. The camera, it actually does that. So I got to wipe it off. Wipe that orange crud off. Yeah, it actually does that. So, yeah, it actually has a little problem with the camera, but nothing too bad. It's not that bad with the overall processor that's inside this thing. So it's not that bad. So I'm going to be testing out PC games, DVD ROM movies, see if it can do that. So yeah, it has a, you know, a charger port on the right hand side of the laptop. It has a DVD drive, a USB 3.1 port, a USB 3.1. I don't know what ports are these, but there are two USB ports on here. You can check it in the description. Go look up Acer Aspire E15, the newest version of the laptop. That's getting 5 stars like crazy on this thing. I'm not even kidding. This laptop is getting 5 stars from every single person like crazy. It is a crazy good laptop. And I cannot wait to actually review this thing to you guys, basically. It is going to be very, 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 very exciting, basically. So I haven't tested out all games yet, but maybe I talked about this once before. Actually, no, I haven't talked about it. Oh, yes. So before I move on, let's talk about some other things that's been going on during the summer. Let's start off with E3. E3 this year was actually pretty dang good this year. It had a really nice potential with games that are coming out. Like, Ubisoft was at the E3 conference on Ubisoft was, all I noticed from that, it was actually kind of long, so I didn't really rush through it. But all I was really excited about was like for some of the exciting game titles, like another like South Park, but you know, like another South Park game that they're coming out. Well, that was actually kind of exciting, but kind of not, because I don't really like South Park all that much. But Ghost Recon Wildlands. Holy crud! It looks really freaking sick. I cannot wait to get it on PS4 so I can go record some video footage for that with you guys. It's going to be really awesome in the sense of the fact that I'll be able to record gameplay footage of Ghost Recon, basically Ghost Recon Wildlands. And it was actually a very similar thing compared to GTA or Far Cry or anything like that. It was another open world game that actually has success, basically. So that's Ghost Recon Wildlands. It's another kind of a GTA 5 copy, but it's not really that bad of a copy of GTA. They're not really trying to copy it, but, you know, basically, oh yeah, that's fireworks outside, I think. But anyways, yeah, that was E3, but let's talk about EA's perspective. The only thing that I was really excited about EA was the, you know, really popular multiplayer game that they had in their library. Not Star Wars Battlefront, because that game was kind of crap, and I will show that, and I will explain that in another video, basically. That is for another video for another time on the Lincoln Williams Show. But anyways, EA pulled out all the guns emblazing on this game. This game looks fantastic with multiplayer. I haven't even seen many multiplayer footage, but the trailers for this game look so freaking good in so many freaking ways. And it looks so good on here. And I want to talk about, it's Battlefield 1. Why are they calling it Battlefield 1? Well, the main purpose of Battlefield 1 is that they're going back to World War II or World War I. I don't know which one where they're going to do next, but I think it's World War II aspects to it, basically. So, yeah. So they're going back to World War II. There's going to be horseback riding on the desert. You'll be able to, fire, tanks, planes, all these other crazy stuff that's going in the game. That is going to be an exciting title. Now let's move on. Now we're going to go to Bethesda's E3 conference. Bethesda Game Studios have been really good this year with their Fallout 4 DLCs, like the Fallout 4 Workshop, basically. The Fallout 4 Workshop vault, you can create your own vault now in Fallout 4, which they're going to be releasing sometime this fall, basically, or something like that. They're going to be doing another Fallout 4 DLC, so that's always good news. And they're going to be releasing the Dark Brotherhood into the Elder Scrolls Online. It actually is it's actually very exciting news. And there's also another project happening. There's also another project happening on at Bethesda. They're actually recording gameplay footage, and they're actually recording. They actually showed this in alpha at Bethesda Game Studios, but they are making another Elder Scrolls game for the PS4 and Xbox One. Can you guess what it is? The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim is coming to PS4 and Xbox One with freaking mods. Yes, they did full out guns and blazing on mods on consoles. It is going to be amazing. It is going to be an amazing experience once I get done with the PC edition. Oh yeah. I forgot to tell you, I got Skyrim for PC for $10, and it's running on high graphics settings, and it is awesome. Now, the download speed on Skyrim, normal PCs would have to download Skyrim for 1 hour or 4 hours, depending on their graphics processor or downloading processor. Now, but this laptop is so fast with the SSD inside it that it just booted up Skyrim in 8 minutes while downloading. Oh my gosh! It was so crazy when I booted up Skyrim with the SSD card and with the SSD inside it. And oh my gosh. The game looks very good on my PC standards, and it's going out fireworks out there. Someone must be having a party or a barbecue, just blowing out fireworks. She's like, "Yeah, fireworks, boom!" Yeah, let's just light some fireworks on the whole block and just blow everybody's houses up with fireworks. Yeah, it actually is. Very funny, but it's actually really embarrassing because me and my dad looked at the laptop, and my laptop is better than his Windows 10 PC. I'm gonna be doing a review of the laptop, and I'm gonna be testing Gary's mod It's already downloaded, but I need to get all the graphic filters in to make the game run smoother with... oh, yeah. I also got to mention I got a PC game that is the number one PC game on Steam, like on IGN's list of all time. Can you guess what that is? And it was only $4 with this demo thing. Can you guess what it is? I got the orange box with the number one game for PC, Half-Life, Game of the Year Edition with the death matches. You got little death matches. You got all these little Half-Life death match and all these like other stuff with Half-Life 2. So Half-Life 2 is the number one PC game that you should get for your PC. I have not played it yet, but I have seen gameplay footage, and it is very similar to Gary's mod. Now I'm gonna be powering up Gmod, see if it's faster on this laptop than than it's on Chris's. Cause if it's faster on my laptop than Chris's, I'm gonna be so embarrassed. I'm going to be so embarrassed, and I'm like, Chris, you need to upgrade your PC, man. You need to upgrade it with an SSD inside it. It's so freaking fast, basically. I cannot wait to test Gary's mod out on this thing. I'm so excited to be flying around the TARDIS on Doctor Who with my sonic screwdriver running around, finding the Weeping Angels, and it's going to be freaking awesome. And stuff like that, and playing on all brand new maps, like space maps. And on Gary's mod, they added Ocarina of Time map. They added the Ocarina of Time map, but it's not the full version yet. But they got a couple places from Ocarina of Time, so I can play on there. So, yeah, it actually is really good. So, I better wrap up this review, but yeah, my summer has been going very well. I've been working hard at Albertsons from 9 to 3. My days off are on Sunday and Thursday if you guys want to hang out one of these days and play on my new gaming PC, and maybe me and Patrick Light Mighty Jedi basically wants to play with me on Smash Brothers Brawl, like a Smash Brothers Brawl edition. So I'm going to be using Snake and Samus, basically, based on my two characters, based on the recording goes well or not. But that's the new updates for me and Light-Minded Jedi, basically. So I mentioned his name a little bit earlier, but anyways. Not his full name, but anyways. But Season 7, the newest thing about Season 7 is this new high-tech laptop camera and another category of reviewing games. What platform do we get on the Lincoln Williams Show? PC gaming reviews. PC gaming reviews on the Lincoln Williams Show. All right, YouTubers, I better wrap it up because it's getting late. And I actually got to play a little bit of Skyrim, a little bit of Gary's mod in my room. So, yeah, it's been a long talk for 24 minutes. But, anyways, and there's fireworks going on outside. I don't even know what the heck is happening out there. But my next review... for the PC is The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. Yes, my next PC review is going to be The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. I'm going to check out the Elder Scrolls series review, and I'm going to take that off and replace it with the PC edition of the review, basically. So, anyways, I will see you guys all later on the next episode of the Lincoln Williams Show. Until then, I will see you guys all later. I'll be back someday, YouTubers.